Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming here tonight to learn about the Heritage Home Program. This is something that the City of Solon has partnered with the Cleveland Restoration Society on to be able to bring this program to homeowners in Solon who have a home that's at least 50 years old or older, and you're going to do a renovation project. You can't have already started that project, but if you plan on doing one, whether it's interior, exterior, or both, you're in the right place for getting some expert guidance and also some low interest financing, which is really great. You're here probably because you received a letter in the mail from Mayor Krause. Thank you, Mayor Eddie Krause, for being here tonight and being so supportive of this very important program. I'm Angie Shaker, the Economic Development Director. Obviously, housing is very important to me, and it's important that we take care of our homes and we maintain them. But we also realize how expensive renovation projects are, so we hope this program helps you out. We did try this in 2012, and I think there wasn't a lot of interest, so the city didn't renew the program. I think it's because a lot of the homes, as many, weren't as eligible, and there just wasn't the interest. But now, 14 years later, over 41% of our homes are eligible, and that takes us to a little over 3,100 homes. So we're happy to see everyone here tonight. I'd like to introduce from the Heritage Home Program to come up here is Chuck Kaczynski. He will be one of the speakers. He is the Heritage Home Program Assistant, and also Jasmine Prezenkowski, and she's the Heritage Home Program Team Leader. So thank you both for being here tonight. We appreciate it.
Angie, thank you very much. Mayor, thank you for hosting this. I'd like to introduce myself in the program. My name is Chuck Kaczynski. I'm a project associate or assistant, and basically my job is to contact individuals looking to do renovation work on their home. So I try to catch as many of you as possible as I could on the way in. There's a sign-up sheet by the window. If you haven't signed in, please do so on your way out. We'll be sending you some information, and you'll have contact information this way. If you have any questions, you can contact us immediately. So what I'd like to do in the first part of the presentation is give you a little background of the Heritage Home Program, our parent organization, the Cleveland Restoration Society, and just give you a taste of what the Heritage Home Program does. Okay. So the Cleveland Restoration Society is part of the Cleveland Restoration Society. And the Cleveland Restoration Society has been around since 1972. And it started as an organization that worked on institutional preservation. We do a lot of work with historically black churches in the city. We've done some things with the Civil Rights Trail. So this is when people think about historical renovation and preservation, they think about that. So we've been doing this for a while, but then people started to think, well, what about the history that people live in? So the Heritage Home Program emerged out of an effort in two historical districts in Cleveland to maintain and to improve those houses. And then over time, since 1992, we've started to look at other communities. So we do a number of programs, including things like aging in place, so that people can spend more time in their homes. Because for most people, this is a major investment in your life. And if you think about it, a lot of your personal history is within those four walls. And so part of our job is to allow you to maintain that historical connection to your home. Okay, so The Heritage Home Program, like I said, has been around since 1992. We have three or four major objectives. We're looking for positive reinvestment in your homes. So for those individuals that are looking to stay and then maybe decide they need to sell their home, the work that we provide helps you with that, that reinvestment. Secondly, for a lot of cities, the increased property value will help with real estate taxes. So it's sort of a win-win situation. Investor confidence, neighborhood stability. The way this was explained to me when I was doing some graduate work is think about the idea of like when one tooth goes bad, the mouth starts to look bad. So it's the idea of if one home has a problem, you might see homes in the other in the surrounding area having problems. So if someone takes care of their home, it's almost like a carryover effect. It maintains not only their property, but the property around that home. And this process of maintaining one home and its carryover effect was proven in two studies that a professor at Cleveland State University did pre and post COVID. So the idea here is that the study has found that over time, neighborhoods and areas which have used the Heritage Home Program, their foreclosure rates were significantly lower. So again, not only is it the benefit for you as an individual homeowner, but it's a benefit for your neighborhood and for the city of Solon. So we have a couple of general requirements. The first is the home needs to be 50 years or older. I get a lot of calls from homeowners saying, my home really isn't historical. And then I ask them and they're like, well, it's done in 1962 or 1954. By our definition, that's historical. So it's 50 years or older. The unit itself has to have three units or less. So if you're talking about a major apartment complex, that won't really fall into our situation. Some condos do qualify. And then lastly, and most importantly, and this is why we're so excited to be in Solon, the houses need to be in participating communities. We have two components that the Heritage Home Program is involved in. I'm going to talk about the first one, and then Jasmine will pick up on the second one. So the first one is our free technical advice. So it's assistance, it's on maintaining your home, it's also on home improvements. Now, when we talk about the Heritage Home Program, a lot of people say, well, does my home have to stay the way it is? The answer is not necessarily so. So sometimes I have homeowners say, I have this bathroom from 1950s and it still has the same fixtures and everything. Can I change it? The answer is absolutely yes. Our program is to allow the homeowner to stay in their home as long as they would like. So we do a variety of things under these two, this first umbrella. Okay, so what do you expect with the technical assistance? First is you're going to get impartial advice. We have a number of construction specialists who have been in the business for years, and they're going to give you their professional opinion on any work that needs to be done in your home. So this is a free service, and it's also based on their experience. Along with that, you're going to be getting connected to resources for home repair. And then finally, guidance on preserving, maintaining, and repairing your home. So let me give you sort of a situation in how this usually works. Usually I'll get a phone call from a homeowner that was at a meeting like you are today, and they're going to call me in the next couple of days and say, hey, Chuck, I was at the presentation. I really have Project X. I want to put a new roof in. So the first thing that we usually do is set the homeowner up with a site visit. It's free service, it's 30 minutes. One of our construction specialists is going to come out to your place and you can ask them any and every question you have. Once that's finished, they're going to send me their notes, and I will or one of my colleagues will come up with a site visit follow-up email. That'll have a list of contractors that do the work in your area, along with loan applications that you can fill out to take advantage of the financial part of things. And then the process begins to move from that point on. Sometimes we have homeowners that call up and say, "Hey, Chuck, I have this contractor already. A buddy of mine or my daughter uses contractor. Can I use them?" Answer, absolutely yes. The only thing that we ask is that any contract that you're going to use will be insured, bonded, and licensed. And in fact, that's the way we get a lot of our contractors in our database. People recommend them. And there's nothing better than a homeowner's recommendation, because then this way we can say to the future homeowner, we've seen the work that they do, and it's really top quality stuff. Okay, so I mentioned this a little bit with the site, regarding the site visits. They're 30 minutes. They are scheduled ahead of time. You can either schedule it by calling me or my colleague. You can also do this off of our website. And then what you're going to do is the consultant will come out and you're going to tell them what you'd like done. And they'll give you an idea of a couple of things. One is how much labor will go into it. How long is this going to take? The materials that will be involved. And then more importantly, how to prioritize your projects. So for example, my house, I just had one of our construction specialists come out, and we want to do both interior and exterior work. So I sat down with one of our construction specialists. I said, "Give me an idea of what I need to do first," because I was all over the place. And basically what he did is he gave me a very clear step. Do this first, do this next, and so on. So ideally, our homeowners like to do the in-person ones. But we've also recently set up virtual site visits. These are a little more accessible, and it's the same process, same procedure. You can sign up for this, and one of our construction specialists will contact you, and either through something like FaceTime or any other program like that, you could take them around your house and show them what you want done. So then this way, it's the next best thing, but it's another option that many of our homeowners like to use. So both of these are available on our online scheduler on our website. One of my favorite things, and Jasmine has recently allowed me to do this, is color consultations. We have people that'll contact us and say, "Hey, I had this work done, loved what work has been done in my house, but I really want that house to sparkle," especially with older homes. So what we do is we go back and we consult a number of sources, we consult information from Sherwin-Williams, and we put together a list of palettes for home exteriors. So we do a number of homes that really, they want to go back to Victorian style. We have all that information. And what we do is, again, this is a free service. We set that up and we forward that information to the homeowner. So this is something that we do regularly. You'll see, as you can see with the before and after picture here, the after picture really sort of sparkles, and it really helps to highlight the details. I should come over here because I don't want to be biased. Okay, like I mentioned, the other thing that we do is we provide contractor names, and then along with the regular contractor names, sometimes we have homeowners that call us up and say, "Hey, Chuck, I already got the process started. I contacted some contractors, and I got some estimates. Is there a problem?" And the answer is no. What you can do is you can send us your estimates, and our construction specialists will take a look at them. They'll give you an idea. They'll let you know, is this in the ballpark? Do you have enough materials? All of those kind of things, so that you can say to the contractor, yeah, I'm ready to sign on the dotted line. So this is another service that we provide regularly, and it's actually a good way to double check to make sure that you have everything you need in those contracts. Another element of this, because we're a preservation and restoration organization, we like to find hidden gems. So Jasmine knows a little more about this than I do, but this is kind of a before and after photograph. So what you're seeing here is a home that the homeowner actually contacted us saying, hey, I want to replace the siding on my home. And so once the construction specialist went out and started to take a look at the home, they discovered that there were these cedar sidings on the homes. There were a few that were damaged, but instead of putting siding on it, they took it out and they redid the siding. And if you notice, if you look at the windows, if you can look at the after photograph, you see those yellow details. Those were hidden away. And by taking those out, you had that hidden history reappear. And that really makes the house pop. It brings back that beauty that a lot of our homeowners are looking to maintain. Another side of the HHP program is we provide educational presentation. You're in one right now. This is our general presentation, but we have other presentations that we do occasionally. We do one on Restoration 101. Basically, how do you get started? Where do you go? We've also done a program recently called Aging in Place. I live with my folks. My folks are in their 80s. Both of them have said to me, Chuck, I do not want to leave this house. This is our house. I want to stay here as long as I possibly can. Aging in place allows you to modify your home so that you can stay in it longer. So we've put together a presentation on that. We also do a presentation on researching your home. As a historical preservation organization, we love hearing stories about old homes. And so for a lot of our homeowners, they want to know how to dig into those archives, how to dig into those county records to find that hidden history of their home. So we can provide you with a lot of that. Another thing that is really useful, if you use our service or not, is the preservation toolbox. There's a lot of how-to tips on the website that are really good. Some of them are color, issues of color, things like woodwork. That's free online. More than welcome after tonight's presentation. Go ahead and take a look at our website. There's a lot of information there that can be accessed very easily. So I mentioned a couple times the site visit. If you go to our website, www.heritagehomeprogram.org, you'll see on the far left of our homepage, schedule a home visit with an expert. Click on that, and then you can choose what kind of site visit you want. The only thing you'll need to put in is your city and your zip code, and then you get to select, do you want to do an in-person, or do you want to do a virtual website? And what'll pop up is a calendar of available days and times. Because of the overwhelming response we've had, Jasmine, do you know where we are right now?
We have available for Southeast.
Okay, April, early May, you could do that tonight and set that up, and we could start the ball rolling if you'd like. Okay, so like I said, the technical assistance is sort of the heart and soul. It's what really gets us excited about doing this work. Important thing, though, is for many of you, including myself, how do you pay for it? So this is the part that Jasmine will take over, and she knows all the dollars and cents part.
All right. second half is going to be that lovely low interest financing option that I'm sure a lot of people are interested in. It's why our program has become so popular in the last year. Interest rates are rising out there, and ours has stayed the same, which is phenomenal. So I'm going to go through a little bit about the loan. I'm going to breeze through some projects at the end that are examples, and then we'll close out the presentation and open up for questions, and we'll try to hang around to answer as many questions as possible. So if you're interested in financing a project through us, we have kind of two options. The bottom option there, we don't see very often. That's if you're deciding to self-finance. So both are going to have pretty much the same procedures. It's just, where is that money coming from? In our loan program, as you can see, we have a fixed rate financing. We do work with two banks that I'll talk about in just a moment. We do have some design standards. There are typical construction standards set by Ohio, and then sometimes in certain areas we ask for a little extra. And those are really protections for you, protections for your home. A great example I like to use is on your roof. Ice guard. They usually require 3 feet of ice guard. We require 6 feet of ice guard. Especially with our winters, ice damming can be a really big issue. You don't want that water falling in the sides of your home. And so that extra 6 feet can really add to the protection. And then interior exterior projects do qualify. In a moment, I'll talk about what does not qualify, because it's really easy to kind of pick anything inside and outside. Most of it will come underneath our loan. As I mentioned, homeowner representative services, that's just if you would like to self-finance but would like our help and our protections along the way. Solon's great out there, so this is obviously not the most updated presentation. I clicked the wrong one, but you guys are participating. It's updated on our website. But there are a couple other eligibility requirements if you're interested in the loan. We talked about general earlier. If your home was built in 1974, zoned residential, 3 units or less, in a participating community, that still all applies. If you're working with us for the loan, your home needs to be insured. You need to be on a tax payment plan or up to date on your taxes. You do have to have equity in your home. It is an equity-based product. And if you have questions about that, please talk to your bank. And then you have to have one or less existing loans. It is a secure loan. It's part of the reason that interest rate has stayed so low. So you can have like a mortgage and then our loan, but if you have a mortgage and like a HELOC open, you would have to close one of those before you can get our loan. So it's just a matter of, again, checking what you have open. Some of you might not have any existing loans, liens on your property. That's something that you'll have to discover before coming into us. And then, as mentioned at the very beginning of our presentation, if your project has started, we unfortunately cannot help you. It is for projects that have not started. So this is not an emergency-based loan. This is something that you need to plan kind of in advance. It does take a little bit of time to get through our beginning processes in order to get those funds in. We do like to generally tell people start a season ahead if you can, season or two ahead of time. So if you're doing a spring project, try to plan in the winter, summer project, you know, fall or winter, that sort of deal, just to get things rolling ahead of time. The other thing that's not included on this list that is on our information packet, we do have a limit to how much your home can be valued at. We don't see this becoming an issue too often, but the value of homes has increased as of recent. So if you're below $575,000, all projects will qualify. If you're between 575 and 725, it would be exterior only. And above 725, unfortunately, we cannot help you. But again, if you don't know where to find that information, we only are able to access what is available on the county website. So whatever is listed on the county website for your home, that's what we're going to base our numbers off of. So I talked about what projects are eligible. Pretty much anything from the top of your home all the way down to the basement, interior, exterior, roof, basement waterproofing. We can do drainage outside your home. Inside, we can do mechanicals. We can do some cosmetic changes. So it's a little bit easier to talk about what's not covered. The big one that usually a lot of people are shocked by is vinyl. No vinyl siding, no vinyl windows, no vinyl doors. We don't do any vinyl. If your home is already vinyl, you can still use us. You can just not use our financing to put new vinyl on your home. The reason that we don't do vinyl is we are a historic preservation organization at the core. And historically, although we're getting into the 1970s, properties did not use vinyl on them to to side them for windows. It's also not a great material. It's not as long lasting. Again, we really want these homes to last. We want your home to be taken care of. And vinyl is not a structural material. So for windows, it can warp, especially in the sun. So we're trying to get nicer materials. We do know that vinyl is usually the cheapest. It's being pushed the hardest. There are other options, composites, that have longer lifespans that are a little bit pricier, but generally in the same range. That can be really great products for that. Luxury items. So we won't do tennis courts. We won't do pools. We would, if you do put a pool in, feel free to invite us over. We'd be happy to join you. But again, can't use our financing for that. And then when we talk about exterior of the home and we're talking about the lawn and kind of the green space around your home, we have some gray areas there. So we like to distinguish it between like softscaping and hardscaping. So if you're doing driveways, sidewalks, very basic stamped concrete patios, those would be covered. We can do tree removal that affects your home. This is something we don't see in some of our inner city areas. You guys have a little bit more land. So if you have a tree on the back of your property that's causing issues, we're not really gonna be able to help you with it because it's not affecting your house. But if it's near your home, we can do tree trimming, we can do tree removal. We can help with drainage, retaining walls. If that's an issue, that's something that also would be covered. So we don't, as mentioned there, we don't do fencing. And then outbuildings is kind of unique. If you have a detached garage, we can do that. We can do any garages. We do garages all the time. But if you have a garage and a shed, we're not gonna be able to do your shed. And then finally there, let's say projects in progress. Another great one that we talk about is additions. Some older homes, they're small. They're not exactly what you need, especially if you're a growing family. Things are changing, you need a little bit more space. We can do additions under our project. There's just some stipulations behind them. So we have this handout, it's on our website. We can email it to you, we can mail it to you. Most additions that are gonna be approved are either on the back or the side of the home. We don't like to change the front facade of your home. Again, we're historic preservation based, so we like to keep that character of your home. I did have an addition come in recently that was a great example. They had, they're trying to do some front changes and occasionally we will approve them. They're trying to stick with the original architecture of their home, which we respect. So again, if you're thinking about it, you can always send it in and ask us. You just know that if it's on the front, we might say no. We're also going to look at the size of your addition. We don't want it to overcome the original structure and the roof line. If you have a split level, you can't make it a tri-level. It's got to stay a split level if you're going to use our program. And again, no vinyl. That's usually one that's stopped a lot of additions. If your home's vinyl and you're trying to put vinyl on the addition to match your home, you can find other materials that'll match that original vinyl, but that are not vinyl. So that's just something you might want to consider. With additions, they take a little extra time. So we're going to talk about kind of the application process here. You can have a site visit. If you do not know where to start, a site visit is a great option because you're gonna get great advice. You're gonna get a list of some contractors in your area that might be able to do the job. You're gonna get an idea of how much that project might cost. If you have an idea of what you wanna do, you have a contractor in mind, all you're gonna need to do is fill out our application and send your estimates into us. If you're gonna do a bigger addition project or something that requires drawings, we would need to see those as well. We approve the project. The bank is going to approve you as a person financially. So we're just going to look over that project additions. I mentioned the little bit longer timeline. It might take us a week or so because we have to look over all the specs and look where everything's placed. Once you're approved with us and your estimate will be reviewed by our construction specialist, they want to make sure that your contractor has everything that's on that's necessary. And that will really help if any issue comes up down the line, resolve it automatically. Our contracts supersede your contractor's contract, so we want everything on there to look right, so when we point to it, we can be, hey, you didn't do that, you got to finish that up, or there's going to be some sort of consequence to it. So again, we're trying to do these protections for you to make sure your project is done really well. Then we send you off to the bank. So you finish that approval process with us, you're going to go to the bank. It's about 30 to 45 days through signing at the bank. The bank is gonna ask if we got your application and estimates to verify that we've seen it and that we've approved it. Once you've signed at the bank, it'll take about a week for your funds to be deposited back with us. Your funds are escrowed with us. You don't write a payment to your contractor. You don't have to handle any of that. We release payment to your contractor on your approval. We have to have your written approval before any funds are released. We make sure that inspections are passed, permits are pulled. Again, some of those protections for you as a homeowner if you're working with us in the loan program. So it is, you said the bank 30 to 45 days. So like I said, it does take some time to get through this application-wise. If you're working with a contractor, this is something you might want to talk to them ahead of time. I had some contractor sheets back there. They said contractor on the side. If you're working, you don't have to work with one of our contractors. You can work with whatever contractor you're comfortable with. That sheet will tell them kind of what to expect. It's available on our website. We can also send it to you. But it details how the payment system works with us. It details that we're going to be pulling permits, have inspections, and it details that we have those contracts. And again, this is all available on our website. So if your contractor has questions about what they're signing ahead of time, we can get that to them so that they know and they can read through it. And you can read through it if you'd like. As I mentioned, we're kind of that specialty loan. So again, the funds are just escrowed with us. You don't make those payments. We are requiring the contractors to be licensed and bonded with your city. We're going to check for those inspections if they're necessary. It really just depends on that project. Talk a little bit about the two banks we work with. We work with KeyBank and Third Federal Savings and Loan. KeyBank's going to be our most popular. We do have two KeyBank associates with us here tonight. They'll be around towards the end to answer questions, help anyone out that might have banking questions that we as staff at HHP can't answer. Everything in the blue section there is going to be the same between two banks. Everything in the red is going to be a little different. We have a side-by-side comparison in our information packet, which if you signed up for, you will be receiving, as well as it's available on our website. But they have a fixed interest rate in Solon of 2%. So you're looking at 2% fixed rate for Solon, which is really phenomenal. Minimum loan amount, $3,000. Max is going to be $150,000. So you have a lot of room to play with there for a variety of different projects. And the term year is going to be from 5 to 10 years. All that's going to be determined with you and the bank. The key thing about this loan is that there are no income limits. Anyone can use it. Anyone can apply for it. Whether you're approved or not is up to the bank, of course. But we're not going to stop you from applying depending on your income. There is no prepayment penalty. If you want to start paying that back early, go ahead. What else do we have up here? We'll work with DIY. DIY is a little bit of a complex situation, so if you're interested in DIY, I really suggest you reach out to one of our assistants, talk to us a little bit more, because there's a little bit more involved in doing a DIY project, depending how big it is. It has to do with those permits and inspections that we talked about. You do have to meet the lending requirements of the bank. 660 credit score. 660 debt to income, 50%. And again, please talk to the bank. They can help you out with that if you have further questions. Loan is based on an after rehab appraisal. This is something unique to our loan. So those estimates, why do we require them up front? That is part of your evaluation to see how much you can borrow. So you're going to take those estimates to the bank. They're going to compare them to the value of your home. An appraiser does come out. You don't pay up front. It's all rolled into the loan. That appraiser will take the value of your home and then estimate how much your home would be valued after those projects are completed. That's the amount you can borrow against. So it gives you, depending on the project, a little bit more room for borrowing depending on how big your project is, which can be really helpful for some homeowners. And then finally, we do have some minimal fees. Those are all laid out in our information packet, side by side. Depending on how big your loan is, some of those fees change. Nothing's paid up front. Again, all rolled into the loan. So you don't have to worry about paying anything extraneously. Third Federal is pretty similar. Again, their changes are on the red there. They have a little bit higher interest rate. It's just with the way that the loan is subsidized. We do partner with the county as well, and the county is part of that entity that helps us get that low rate. So they're at 4.99% fixed rate. They work with owner-occupied properties only. I did not mention this, but KeyBank will work with rental properties. There are extra stipulations. So if you're interested in that, we can talk about it again. You can only own a total of 4 properties, including your own home, and we can only help with one of those. And the condition of that home is very important. You cannot have, your walls have to be intact. You have to be able to live in that space. Minimum loan amount, $5,200, so a little bit higher than Key. Same max at $150. 15-year term, so it's a little bit longer. But the thing with Third Federal is that you have to have a certain income. They have a pretty low income. limit of about $68,000 with some change in there. It's listed at the very bottom in fine print on our information packet. So most people are already disqualified from the third federal loan just by the income limit alone. Of course, some people still love Third Federal, no offense to Key Bank, but some people just don't want to work with Key Bank. So it's up to you to decide which bank you would prefer to go with. I mentioned that side-by-side comparison. This is a screenshot of the back of that information packet. Again, on our website, we'll be sending it to you. Details all of that information. Homeowner representative services. This really is just detailing a lot of what I already said. It's the same stuff that's happening in the loan. You're still escrowed with us. You still have the same protections. There's a one-year warranty listed there that's included in our contracts that are signed. There are minimum fees, not the same fees as the bank loan. There are a little bit less. Finalizing a project. So gone through all of that, you got your funds, we paid your contractor, you're in the last steps. Part of our process is that for any payment that has labor on it with your contractor, we're gonna hold back 10%. We call it our retainer. That is to ensure that your project is completed and up to your standards before you release that final payment. So for each payment that has labor, we hold back 10%. At the very end, we're gonna communicate with you. We would love to have a site visit with you to come out, look at that work, make sure it looks really great, make sure you're happy with it. And if you are, then we'll release that retainer back to that contractor. It's kind of like holding something like a carrot on a stick to make sure that they're doing a great job and they finish that work. We've had a lot of issues in Ohio with contractors taking money and running. Something we hear a lot, something we've seen a lot, Ohio code has changed to reflect that. We no longer allow really, really large deposits with contractors because it was such a big issue. So this is just something that we're very conscious of, something that we want to help protect you against. And then once we're done, you're happy to enjoy your home. And hopefully you enjoy well. And so I'm going to go through a couple projects from the past. I'm going to try to breeze through these because I know we've been talking a while. And want to finish up so we can get to your questions. Another painting project. This homeowner actually ran the gamut of our program, came for a site visit, did a color consult, followed up with our loan. And so they were able to use all three parts. This homeowner was replacing a furnace. They had some funds, needed a little extra to cover it. So they actually got the loan, deposited some of their personal funds, and was able to get their new HVA system put in place. Chuck already mentioned this. You don't have to keep your 1960s bathroom, 1970s bathroom. You can have whatever bathroom you like. Cosmetic updates are pretty great and usually pretty simple. I mentioned additions. Very small addition project. This is a little bump out on the side of the home. They had a lot of like their mudroom stuff going into their kitchen, taking up a lot of space. And so by creating this back entrance with some storage, that little addition bump out, they were able to remove that from their kitchen and extend their kitchen space. Complete interior remodels. So you can do a whole interior remodel. You do have to have those walls up beforehand. So that is, it says a before picture, but that's a during picture and an after picture where they were doing an attic space. This was a very large addition project. They wanted to convert their garage into more living, dining, kitchen space. I can't remember which one. And so they did that. And then they added on a new garage. So they still had space for their cars. So pretty big money project there. Garage rebuilds. I'm going to pause here for a moment because we do a lot of garages. If you have a detached garage, that is the one and only place we will allow vinyl. We allow vinyl on garages, one, because it's not your home, so it's not as important to keep intact, and two, garage companies don't often offer other materials. Some will, so if you'd like to do a material that's not vinyl, fantastic, but if they don't worry, we can do vinyl on a detached garage. Solar panels is kind of a new one. I think we had two or three solar panel projects last year, which to me was pretty phenomenal. We don't see them very often, but they're becoming more popular. Similar to an addition project, we're just gonna look to see where you're putting that solar panel, depending on the gable style of your home. And then finally, we do have what people that come back to us. homeowners that have loved our program, used the loan once, paid it off, decided to come back a second time. We've been seeing them a lot this year. Here's something I like to warn people about. You can absolutely do the loan more than once, depending on how many liens, if you qualify. But if you are able, you have the capacity to take on multiple projects, you won't have to pay those fees more than once. There are fees associated with our loan, so if you can lump multiple projects together, that's a really great idea. We say that there is an 18-month time period for you to use those funds. That's pretty flexible. If you're doing a roofing project, it's not going to take you 18 months to get it done. That's usually for the bigger remodeling projects. As long as you keep in touch with us, we're happy to keep, we're going to keep your funds. We just want to know what's going on to make sure that you're okay, that you're still interested in doing projects. This is just a slide that we've done a lot in a lot of areas. We've been around for about 32 years at this point, so a lot of stuff going on. And we're now in 45 communities, so we have expanded substantially over the last year. Now, this page I know is has our staff on it. Chuck presented earlier. We also have Ava, one of our assistants. Our main line is at the top there. So if you call that main line, you will have to leave a message. We do not have anyone to pick up immediately with us working in 45 cities. It tells you on that message it'll take us a couple days to respond. Our response time currently is pretty quick. You won't have to wait more than a couple days, and one of our seasonal staff or assistants will get back to you to answer your questions, give you all the information that you need. You can also email that main inbox as well. If you'd like to get a hold of one of us, though, we have our information from me. So I'm going to close out the presentation portion. So if anyone needs to leave, that is all right. And then I'm going to take time to try to answer homeowner questions because this is our favorite part. And we'll hang around as long as they let us hang around to help you out. Thank you so much for coming.